Welcome to worship with First Grapevine, a United Methodist Church. We're glad you've joined us. Please take a moment and let us know you are watching by registering on our church website, firstgrapevine.org, or on our mobile app. We hope this time will be a blessing. Let's worship together.
Bienvenido a First Grapevine. Nos alegra que se una a nosotros. Tome un momento para registrar su asistencia en nuestro sitio de web o en nuestra aplicación. Esperamos que este mensaje sea una bendición para usted y lo invitamos a compartirlo con otros. Ahora, adoremos juntos.
Buenos días, familia. Queremos darle la más cordial bienvenida a este nuestro servicio bilingüe. Queremos que tomes un momento con tu familia o si estás solo en tu casa, ahí donde estés, para que adoremos juntos en la presencia del Señor. Porque dice la palabra que donde dos o más se reúnen en su nombre, allí Dios estará. Y aquí estamos tú y yo reunidos en este momento para adorar. We want to give you the most warm welcome to all of you that have joined us for our bilingual service. We want to ask you that you gather your family, that you gather yourself, and to join us as we worship our God. The Word of God says that wherever two or more are gathered, there the presence of God will be. And you and I are here together, gathered in God's presence, so let us worship. Dios eterno, te agradecemos por la oportunidad de adorarte y exaltar tu nombre en este momento. Levantamos nuestras manos y nuestro corazón en tu presencia, declarando que tú eres nuestro Dios. Te pedimos que llenes nuestro corazón de tu presencia e ilumines nuestra mente. Dear God, we are coming to you to worship you and honor, and we ask as we lift our hands and our heart into your presence that you bring comfort to our minds and our hearts. We praise you and we honor you in everything that we do here. Amen.
Please join with me as we raise our voices and affirm our faith together with the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Good morning, Ian, Parker, Nicholas, Trevor, Brandon, Emma, Audrey, and Isabel, and all my friends watching. I'm going to talk to you today about a pretty serious subject that the Bible is very clear about. It's called injustice. It's defined as lack of fairness or justice. I think most of you are pretty familiar with lack of fairness because I hear you saying, "That's not fair," all the time. Think about it. How often do you say that, or at least think it? I know I'm guilty of thinking that's not fair frequently. In our country today, there's some unfairness around skin color. In some cases, people without white skin like mine are not being treated as fairly as I am, or as fairly as some of you are. We are created in God's image. In other words, created to reflect God, and that could only be good, right? In the Psalms in July, we heard, "We are fearfully and wonderfully made." Last week, we talked about when God completed creation, he said it was good. It was very good. So when God created you, knitted you together in your mama's womb, he created a beautiful thing, someone very good, whether your skin is red, white, yellow, brown, or black, all are beautiful. Miss Monica and I have been talking about how important this message is for everyone to hear. We will be reading some very good books on this topic to you every Monday, posting our stories on the Family Ministries Facebook page. Because we want you, as followers of Jesus, to remember that you and all people were created beautifully by God, and all are very good. Did you get that? If you did, say, "Got it." Got it. Before I go, I want to give you a blessing. So hold your hand up. You know how this goes. And imagine I'm looking you right straight in the eyes, and I'm calling you by name. I'm making the sign of the cross on your hand and reminding you that God loves you. You are a blessing, and I love you too. Amen.
One of the things we get to do together as a community of faith is pray for one another.
Una cosa que podemos hacer como una comunidad de fe es orar para nosotros.
Let us pray.
Vamos a orar.
God, you are the creator of the world, and we thank you that you made creation very good.
Dios, tú eres el creador del mundo, y te damos gracias por todo lo que has creado, porque todo lo que has creado es bien bonito.
We thank you for the beautiful weather, for the friends that we get to see, for the ways that we're connecting with one another.
Te damos gracias por el clima, Dios, por todos los amigos que podemos ver y por todas las diferentes maneras que podemos conectarnos con todos.
We pray especially for those who are struggling right now.
Oramos especialmente para todos los que están batallando ahorita.
God, for those who are sick, we pray for healing, we pray for comfort, and we pray that in this time of social distancing, that they know that they're not alone.
Oramos por todos los enfermos ahorita que se recuperen, que se sienten mejor, Dios. Oramos para que sepan ellos que ahorita en estos tiempos más difíciles no están solos.
For those who feel lonely, God, help us to be the hands and feet of Christ to them.
Por los que están, por todos los que se sienten isolados y se sienten solos, Dios, oramos para ser los pies y las manos de ti y ayudarlos.
For teachers, God, as they head back to work and prepare for students in a new way, God, be with them.
Por todos los maestros, Dios, que están regresando ahorita a la escuela tratando de enseñar y ayudar a los niños en diferentes maneras, Dios, oramos por ellos.
And be with us all as we continue to figure out new ways to be the church and to live in this different world.
Y que estés con nosotros, Dios, ahorita en estos tiempos que estamos tratando de ver cómo podemos vivir en estos tiempos tan difíciles.
God, we remember that you liberate us from our fears and from the things that we're trapped in.
Dios, nosotros sabemos que tú nos liberas de todos nuestros miedos y todas las cosas que nos atrapan.
So be with us, God, and when we are short for words, we remember the prayer you taught us.
Entonces mantente con nosotros, Dios, y cuando nos olvidamos, cuando no tenemos palabras, que recordemos la oración que tu hijo nos enseñó.
Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Padre nuestro que estás en el cielo, santificado sea tu nombre. Venga a nosotros tu reino en la tierra como en el cielo.
Give us this day our daily bread and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us.
Danos nuestro pan de cada día y perdona nuestras ofensas como también nosotros perdonamos a los que nos ofenden.
And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever.
Y no nos dejes caer en la tentación y aléjanos de todo mal, porque tuyo es el reino, el poder y la gloria para siempre. Amén.
Amén.
I want to begin our time together here with a reading from Matthew's Gospel, the third chapter, beginning the reading with verse 13 and reading through verse 17, another baptism in another outdoor place. Let us have ears to hear this great story. Then Jesus came from Galilee to the Jordan to be baptized by John. But John tried to deter him, saying, "I need to be baptized by you, and do you come to me?" Jesus replied, "Let it be so now, John. It is proper for us to do this, to fulfill all righteousness." Then John consented. As soon as Jesus was baptized, he went up out of the water. At that moment, heaven was opened, and he saw the Spirit of God descending like a dove and lighting on him. And a voice from heaven said, "This is my Son, whom I love. With him I am well pleased." The Word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Let us pray. Oh God, as we gather here on this summer eve, we hear these powerful words about our Savior's baptism. And we sense the power of your presence in it and through it as we hear it. And oh God, it is no different here with us this evening, for your presence is here with us too. And we claim that. And we open ourselves to this sacred and holy time together. We thank you for the blessing of new life, for the love of Mike and Megan and their expression of it that now have brought Madison into this family and into this world and into this fellowship of community. We thank you for all who are here tonight, for those, oh God, who will be watching and participating too. Now bless us and this time. In the name and spirit of the risen Lord we pray. Amen.
Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. Little ones to him belong, they are weak, but he is strong. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so.
We are gathered here today to witness and celebrate the baptism of Madison Bond. Baptism is the sacrament by which we welcome persons into the community of faith, the body of Christ, naming the redeeming presence in her life. Although Madison cannot make that decision for herself yet. We recognize God is already at work in her life. And she has been named a child of God. Today, using the powerful symbol of water, we recognize her uniqueness created through God's love in the covenant relationship of marriage between Mike and Megan. This water represents to us the cleansing, fresh newness of life as God's grace is present in the life of Madison, not only today, but always. And so, this water symbolizes to us new life, a new beginning. And it is a powerful symbol of what it means to be God's child in the world. And as God's child, to be loved completely and perfectly. And as God's child, at some point in Madison's life where she claims that love for herself, that love will move and work through her as she seeks to be a living example, an expression of such love to all of those she knows, meets, and sees. Let us pray. Oh God, we ask your blessing and your presence to be over this water. And we are reminded of the baptism of Jesus as we have heard it read, and the power and presence of you there as you are here with us. And as that same water was used as a part of a symbolic statement about him, it is used here today as a symbolic representation that Madison is your child. And as such, she is loved now, tomorrow, and always by you. In the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, we ask your blessing upon this water. Amen. To you, Mike and Megan, I ask this question. Will you continue to live faithfully as followers of Christ Jesus and raise Madison to know the triune God? To those of you who are gathered, to those of you who will be watching, I ask this question. Will you nurture Madison and lead her in the way of God in Christ, present through the Holy Spirit, until that day she can make her own decision to love him and follow him? If you would respond, we will. Thank you. Madison Bond, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. And may God's Holy Spirit keep you, be with you, love you, and lead you all the days of your life from now until forevermore. Amen. Oh, she did very good. For those of you who are watching, for those of you who are here, know this. This is the newest member of God's family here at First Grapevine. So Madison, we welcome you. For those of you who are watching, I want to say to you, as we receive this family and this child as a baptized person of God's family, to write notes, send us emails, and we'll make sure that they get to this family as our way of showing from the beginning our encouragement, our love, and the community that we will form around them and certainly around her as we make this sacred and holy journey together. Let us pray. Oh God, we are blessed tonight beyond compare. As we once again are reminded of not only who Madison is, but of who we are as your children, and what a blessing that is to us all, we ask that you may be with Madison, that as we have confirmed here, that she, O God, by the love of this family, by the support of these friends, and as the members of the church, as we love and nurture her in the way of loving, your loving, until that day, O God, that she makes that decision for herself, we thank you for this family. And we ask your blessing upon Michael and Megan as they seek to be good and loving parents, as they nurture her to be the person that you have created her to be. And may she always know, O God, wherever the journey of life takes her, that she is yours, and as yours, she is loved. O Lord, thank you for this gift. Now help all of us as we seek not only to receive it, but to nurture, to care, to love, to grace, to guide, to direct, and to be there for her all along her way. In the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, we pray. Amen. Well, thank you for being here. I think a round of applause. You bet. Madison, you were awesome.
I'll be reading from Exodus 14, verses 10 through 14, and verses 21 through 31. As Pharaoh drew closer, the Israelites looked back and saw the Egyptians marching toward them. The Israelites were terrified and cried out to the Lord. They said to Moses, "Weren't there enough graves in Egypt that you took us away to die in the desert? What have you done to us by bringing us out of Egypt like this? Didn't we tell you the same thing in Egypt? Leave us alone. Let us work for the Egyptians. It would have been better for us to work for the Egyptians than to die in the desert." But Moses said to the people, "Don't be afraid. Stand your ground and watch the Lord rescue you today. The Egyptians you see today, you will never see again. The Lord will fight for you. Just keep still." Then Moses stretched out his hand over the sea. The Lord pushed the sea back by a strong east wind all night, turning the sea into dry land. The waters were split into two. The Israelites walked into the sea on dry ground. The waters formed a wall for them on their right hand and on their left. The Egyptians chased them and went into the sea after them, all of Pharaoh's horses and chariots and cavalry. As morning approached, the Lord looked down on the Egyptian camp from the column of lightning and a cloud and threw the Egyptian camp into a panic. The Lord jammed their chariot wheels so that they wouldn't turn easily. The Egyptians said, "Let's get away from the Israelites because the Lord is fighting for them against Egypt." Then the Lord said to Moses, "Stretch out your hand over the sea so that the water comes back and covers the Egyptians, their chariots and their cavalry." The waters returned and covered the chariots and the cavalry, Pharaoh's entire army that had followed them into the sea. Not one of them remained. The Israelites, however, walked on dry ground through the sea. The waters formed a wall for them on their right hand and on their left. The Lord rescued Israel from the Egyptians that day. Israel saw the Egyptians dead on the seashore. Israel saw the amazing power of the Lord against the Egyptians. The people were in awe of the Lord, and they believed in the Lord and in his servant Moses. This is the word of God for you, the people of God. Thanks be to God.
La escritura de hoy viene de Éxodos, capítulo 14, versículos 10 al 14 y 21 al 31. El faraón iba acercándose. Cuando los israelitas se fijaron y vieron a los egipcios pisándole los talones, sintieron mucho miedo y clamaron al Señor. Entonces le reclamaron a Moisés, ¿acaso no había sepulcros en Egipto que nos sacaste de allá para morir en el desierto? ¿Qué has hecho con nosotros? ¿Para qué nos sacaste de Egipto? Ya en Egipto te decíamos, déjanos en paz, preferíamos servir a los egipcios. Mejor nos hubiera sido servir a los egipcios que morir en el desierto. No tengan miedo, les respondió Moisés, mantengan sus posiciones que hoy mismo serán testigos de la salvación que el Señor realizará en favor de ustedes. A esos egipcios que hoy ven, jamás volverán a verlos. Ustedes quédense quietos, que el Señor presentará batalla por ustedes. Moisés extendió su brazo sobre el mar y toda la noche el Señor envió sobre el mar un recio viento del este que lo hizo retroceder, convirtiéndolo en tierra seca. Las aguas del mar se dividieron y los israelitas lo cruzaron sobre tierra seca. El mar era para ellos una muralla de agua a la derecha y otra a la izquierda. Los egipcios los persiguieron, todos los caballos y carros del faraón y todos sus jinetes entraron en el mar tras ellos. Cuando ya estaba por amanecer, el Señor miró al ejército egipcio desde la columna de fuego y de nube y sembró la confusión entre ellos. Hizo que las ruedas de sus carros se atascaran, de modo que se les hacía muy difícil avanzar. Entonces exclamaron los egipcios, «Alejémonos de los israelitas, pues el Señor está peleando por ellos y contra nosotros». Entonces el Señor le dijo a Moisés, «Extiende tu brazo sobre el mar, para que las aguas se vuelvan contra los egipcios y contra sus carros y jinetes». Al recobrar las aguas su estado normal, se tragaron a todos los carros y jinetes del faraón y a todo el ejército que había entrado al mar para seguir a los israelitas. Ninguno de ellos quedó con vida. Los israelitas, sin embargo, cruzaron el mar sobre tierra seca, pues para ellos el mar formó una muralla de agua a la derecha y otra a la izquierda. En ese día el Señor salvó a Israel del poder de Egipto. Los israelitas vieron los cadáveres de los egipcios tendidos a la orilla del mar. Y al ver los israelitas el gran poder que el Señor había desplegado en contra de los egipcios, temieron al Señor y creyeron en él y en su siervo Moisés. Esa es la palabra de Dios para el pueblo de Dios. Damos gracias a Dios.
The coronavirus is raging and on the move.
Police lost control of downtown.
Protesters have taken to the streets in Portland.
Millions of Americans may soon face eviction.
Millions of Americans will lose the extra $600.
Hospitalizations in Texas are at a record high.
Tonight, a nation on edge and up in smoke.
The U.S. saw a single-day record.
The CDC is laying out its guidelines.
Similar monuments are being removed.
The nation erupted into scenes of chaos.
The news of the day is all around us. We see it, hear it, and read it every day. Much of the news we are exposed to is negative, disturbing, confusing, and downright scary. But in the middle of our turbulent world, the good news is there is good news.
Amigos de Grapevine, sabemos que estamos viviendo en tiempos sin precedente. Parece que cada minuto que pasa las noticias se vuelven más y más complicadas y más difícil de procesar. Nos podemos ahogar en este mar de confusión y de malas noticias. Es por eso que aquí en Grapevine hemos empezado una nueva serie de las buenas nuevas de nuestro Dios. En esta serie queremos recordarnos los unos a los otros que nuestra confianza está puesta en Dios, porque Dios es el creador, Dios es el liberador, Dios es el que nos hizo a su imagen y semejanza, y es entre medio de Dios y a través de Dios que Él continúa haciendo cosas en ti y en mí para hacer este mundo mejor. Te invitamos a que te conectes con nosotros a través de esta serie en el mes de agosto, Las Buenas Nuevas. Sean bendecidos y nos vemos.
Esta semana, como has podido notar, continuamos nuestra serie de las buenas nuevas. La semana pasada tuvimos la oportunidad de escuchar al pastor Alan junto a nuestro amigo haciendo la translation para nosotros en bilingual, y estamos contentos y agradecidos por su colaboración. Hoy continuamos Nuestra serie con Dios es el liberador. This week, as we continue the story of God's creation and the good news, we come to you with a grateful heart for Pastor Alan, who was able to deliver a message last week for us. We are thankful for him and our translating friend that were able to give us deliver such a great message. Esta semana continuamos nuestra serie y podemos ver el poder liberador de Dios. Esta semana somos testigos de la culminación de la historia de cómo los israelitas escaparon después de 400 años de esclavitud y opresión bajo los egipcios. La historia hoy se centra en la parte en la cual los israelitas están saliendo de Egipto. Esto pasó ya después de las plagas, después de que Faraón finalmente decide dejar ir a los israelitas. This week, as we continue our series, The Good News, we set to see the liberating power of God. We can witness this in the culmination of the story of how the Israelites escaped after over 400 years of slavery and oppression under the Egyptians. The story of today centers in the part in which the Israelites are on the way out of Egypt. This is after the plagues and after Pharaoh finally decides to let the Israelites go. Sin embargo, al salir, la Escritura nos dice que Dios cambió el corazón de Faraón, llevándolo a perseguir a los israelitas mientras se dirigían en su camino hacia la libertad. However, on the way out, the scripture tells us that God changed the heart of Pharaoh, leading them and his army to go after the Israelites as they headed out towards freedom. Si leemos el texto completo, te invito a que lo leas, que podríamos ver cómo los israelitas llegaron al lugar exacto. Estaban frente al mar y a sus espaldas se encontraba el ejército egipcio. Descubriríamos, si leemos toda la historia, que había una distancia más corta que podrían haber pasado. Pero esa es la ruta que los hubiera puesto frente a frente con otro ejército, llevándolos a una batalla. Pero Dios sabía que los israelitas no estaban listos para enfrentar ese desafío. En lugar de enviarlos a una batalla, Dios los envió frente al mar con el ejército egipcio a sus espaldas. If we read the story of how the Israelites got to the exact place in front of the sea, we will discover that there was a shorter route that could have taken them through much faster. However, it would have put them in a fight against another army. But because God knew that the Israelites were not ready to face that challenge, instead, God put them in front of the sea with the upcoming Egyptian army in their backs. Frente a esa nueva realidad, los israelitas tenían una decisión que tomar: marchar hacia adelante, hacia el mar y ahogarse, o retroceder y rendirse a la conocida seguridad de la opresión y la esclavitud que vivían debajo de los egipcios. En su lamentación, en su desesperación, los israelitas clamaron a Moisés y le dijo, porque habría sido mejor para nosotros servir bajo los egipcios que morir en el desierto. Faced with the new reality of whether heading forward into the sea and drown or turn back to where they came from and surrender into the known safety of slavery and the oppression, the Israelites had a choice to make. For it would have been better for us to serve the Egyptians and to die in the wilderness. This was the words of the Israelites as they faced what they thought was a sure death. Todos nos podemos identificar con esta historia. Nos puede hablar a todos en tantas formas. Nos puede hablar en tantas formas porque nos conecta. Nos puede hablar a todos en los caminos que seguimos porque estamos interconectados. Muchos de ellos están paralelos y a la misma vez nuestros caminos están distantes. La verdad es que nuestra experiencia de Dios como libertador dependerá en gran medida de nuestro origen nacional y hasta el color de nuestra piel. Sin embargo, el poder del testimonio de la Escritura puede traer un mensaje de liberación a todos nosotros. Independientemente de nuestras circunstancias, el poder liberador de Dios es algo que todos podemos creer y todos podemos esperar. This story can speak to all of us in so many ways, interconnectedly, parallel, and in distant ways. The truth is that our experience of God as a liberator will greatly depend on our national origin and the color of our skin. Nevertheless, the power of the witness of this scripture can uniquely bring a message of liberation to all of us. Regardless of our circumstances, the liberating power of God is something that we can all believe in and we can all hope for. Puede que necesites libertad en tu corazón, liberación para creer y confiar en Dios. Usted puede estar creyendo y buscando la libertad de una adicción o simplemente necesita el poder liberador de Dios capaz de romper todas las cadenas en nuestros corazones. No importa nuestros caminos, esta historia nos trae esperanza de un Dios que nos rescata y nos trae libertad, ya sea física, emocional o espiritual. You may be in need of freedom in your heart, freedom to be able to believe and trust in God. You may be believing and seeking for freedom from an addiction or just need of the liberating power of God, which is capable to break every chain in our hearts. No matter our paths, this story can bring us hope, rescue us, and bring us freedom, whether it's physical, emotional, or spiritual. Al estudiar la historia de mi pueblo y mi patria, esta historia de liberación tiene una trama complicada, sobre todo porque la historia de mi pueblo, de manera similar a la historia de muchos de nuestros países latinoamericanos y la misma historia de la América Negra, nuestras historias de liberación están llenas de conquistadores y opresores que vienen a nuestra tierra y contra nuestros cuerpos y dicen ser enviados por Dios. De muchas maneras, los negros y los latinos siguen esperando y buscando su liberación física, emocional y hasta espiritual. As I study the story of my own people and my homeland, this story of liberation has a bit of a complicated plot for me. Mostly because the story of my people, similarly to the story of many of our Latin American countries, and the story of Black Americans, our stories of liberations are filled with conquistadores and oppressors coming into our land and against our own bodies, claiming to be God sent. So in many ways, Black and brown communities are still waiting and seeking for liberation, physical, emotional, and spiritual. Pero si algo nos ha mostrado la historia de los israelitas es que la libertad a menudo es más que un momento. La libertad a veces puede venir en forma de un proceso. A lo largo de ese proceso nos encontramos en momentos y situaciones cruciales que determinarán el progreso y el avance de las libertades que buscamos. But it's something we have learned, or we could learn, of the story of the Israelites is that freedom is so often more than just a moment. Freedom sometimes can come in the form of a process. And throughout that process, we find ourselves in crucial moments and junctions that will determine the progress and advancement of the freedoms that we seek. Aquí es donde encontramos a los israelitas en su búsqueda de la libertad en esta historia. Un ejército marchando hacia ellos y delante de ellos lo que parece ser una muerte segura. En ese momento fueron todos tentados a volver a la seguridad porque el camino por delante se veía incierto y difícil. Moisés le respondió a los israelitas cuando se estaban tentados a volver a sus circunstancias, les dice: no tengan miedo, mantengan sus posiciones, porque hoy mismo serán testigos de la salvación que el Señor realizará por ustedes. Quédense quietos, les decía, que el Señor peleará por ustedes. Pero sin embargo, después de que Moisés pronunció estas palabras que querían traer aliento y consolar al pueblo de Dios, Dios interrumpió a Moisés y le dice: ¿por qué me estás clamando a mí? ¿Qué estás haciendo? ¿Qué estás esperando? Ordena a los israelitas que sigan adelante. No hay que quedarse calmado o quieto. Hay que marchar hacia adelante, le dice el Señor a Moisés. This is where we find the Israelites today in their quest for freedom in this story. An army marching towards them, and ahead of them what seems like certain death. It was so tempting to revert back to the safety of the oppression because the road ahead just seemed uncertain and difficult. But Moses said to them, "Do not be afraid. Stand firm and see the deliverance that God will accomplish for you. The Lord will fight for you. You have to only keep still." However, after Moses delivered those words that seek to bring comfort and strength to the people of God, God called out to Moses and said, "Why are you crying to me? Why are you waiting for? Why are you standing still? Tell the Israelites to go forward." Yo creo que nosotros hemos entrado a uno de esos momentos cruciales, esos cruces que determinan el progreso y el avance de nuestras libertades. Y mientras algunos de nosotros podríamos estar volviéndonos a Dios y llorando para liberarnos, Dios nos está diciendo hoy: ¿por qué me llamas? Levántate y marcha hacia adelante. Pero todo lo que vemos delante de nosotros es un mar de incertidumbre. Estamos tentados a volver al dolor, a los vicios, a las actitudes y a la opresión que conocemos, porque es aterrador enfrentarse a lo desconocido. Pero hoy Dios nos está diciendo que avancemos con fe. I believe that we have come into one of those crucial moments and junctions as a community and as people that will determine the progress and advancements of our own freedoms. And while some of us might be turning to God, crying to God to deliver us, God is telling us today, "Why are you crying to me for? What are you waiting for? Go forward." But all we can see ahead of us is a sea of uncertainty. And we are all tempted to go back to the pain, the vices, the attitudes, and the oppression that we know, because it is just too scary sometimes to face the unknown. But today, God is telling us, go forward in faith. That is why we believe that God is creating and God is liberating. And as individuals and Christians, we march forward to continue the transformation, liberation that God throughout Christ can bring into our lives. God today continues to bring liberation. Notice that Jesus' very first message was his mission to bring freedom to the captives. And our job as children of God and as the church is not over until everyone have access to experience the liberating power of God in their lives. And we must not lose sight that God uses people just like he used Moses to bring forth that message of encouragement to lead us into that freedom. And God is asking us today, in the same way he asked Moses so many, many thousand years ago, to use every tool that we have at hand to open a path for ourselves. And we are not to stand still and wait around for freedom to come to us anymore. As we are called to lift our rod, to lift our hands, and to lift our voices, and let us go forward towards liberation. Por eso creemos que Dios está creando, y Dios es un Dios liberador. Como individuos y como cristianos, avanzamos para continuar la liberación transformadora que Dios, a través de Cristo, puede traer a nuestra vida. Dios continúa trayendo liberación. Les recuerdo que el primer mensaje que Jesús compartió de su misión fue el llevar la libertad a los cautivos. Y nuestro trabajo como hijos de Dios y como iglesia no termina hasta que todos tengan acceso a experimentar el poder liberador de Dios en sus vidas. No debemos perder de vista que Dios utiliza a personas, al igual que usó a Moisés tantos años atrás para llevar ese mensaje de aliento y llevarnos hacia libertad. Hoy Dios nos dice la misma manera que le dijo a Moisés: utiliza todas las herramientas que tienes a la mano para abrir un camino para nosotros mismos. No debemos quedarnos quietos y esperar a que la libertad venga a nosotros. Levantemos nuestra vara, levantemos nuestras manos, levantemos nuestra voz y sigamos hacia adelante, hacia el Dios liberador. Sean bendecidos.
As we enter into our time of giving, we give because our God gives so freely to us.
Llegando al tiempo de dar, nosotros empezamos a dar porque Dios siempre nos ha dado a nosotros.
And although church looks different this way these days, we are still being the hands and feet of Christ in this world.
Y aunque la iglesia se ve diferente en estos días, todavía seguimos siendo los pies y las manos de Dios sobre todo el mundo.
Your gifts make that possible, and for that we are extremely grateful.
Sus regalos hacen todo esto posible y por eso les damos muchas gracias.
May God bless your gifts as richly as God blesses all of us.
Que Dios bendiga sus regalos tanto como nos bendice a todos nosotros.
Abre mis ojos, oh Cristo. Abre mis ojos, Señor. Yo quiero verte. Yo quiero verte.
Gracias por compartir con nosotros este momento de adoración. Y ahora nos despedimos en el nombre del Señor. We thank you for joining us for worship today. And today we are sending you with a blessing. Vayan en el amor de Dios, llenos de alegría y esperanza, sabiendo que Dios está siempre con ustedes. Y que la paz de Dios, que sobrepasa todo entendimiento, guarde sus corazones y mentes. Amén.
For current information about the effects of COVID-19 precautions at First Grapevine Church, visit firstgrapevine.org/COVID-19updates.
Para información al día sobre los efectos de COVID-19 precauciones en la iglesia First Grapevine, visiten firstgrapevine.org/COVID-19updates.